Hello friends and welcome to NAC Graphics. This is my very first lesson on Adobe Illustrator. And in this lesson, we will learn about creating a new document. When you open up the Illustrator, a blank interface appears like this. For creating a new document, you go to the File menu and click New. The New Document dialog box will appear. Now let us learn about the options appearing in this dialog box. The first thing is the name. It's pretty simple. Just enter any desired name you want to put for your document. Illustrator also gives a default name to every new document as Untitled, followed by the numeric order. The second thing is profile. Illustrator has many preset document profiles to be used. The width and the height of the document get set according to the profile chosen. Like if I choose Print Profile, the width and height will adjust accordingly. The profile you set has many sub-options to be set. Like if you select Print Profile, the sub-options related to this size would be letter, A4, A3, etc., which are recognized industry standard sizes. However, you can set your own desired sizes by putting values in width and height column. You can also save your own profile preset. Just set the figures below as desired by you. Like I have set the width and the height values to be 30 points. And a new document will be opened. Now go to the File menu, choose Save As, and browse to this folder. And save your profile with desired name, like I have saved it as Icon. Save as type should be Adobe Illustrator, that is AI file. Now if you again go to the new command, see the list of profiles, and there you have your own built profile. Then we have number of artboards. Artboard means number of pages in a document. Along with that, you have an option to set the alignment of the artboards. This option will be dimmed if you have one artboard. Here I increase the number of artboards to be say 6. So these alignment options ask me to how to arrange order of pages. We have 4 options here, which are grid by row, grid by column, arrange by row, and arrange by column. If you have chosen this option of alignment of artboards, that is grid by row, Illustrator will ask you how many columns you want. And if the number of columns you set is 2, then the alignment of artboards will be like this. 6 artboards are gridded row-wise and are divided by 2 columns. The page number or the artboard number flows row-wise like this. If you choose the grid by column, it will ask you how many rows you want and will set the alignment accordingly. This option of arrange by row will arrange all the artboards in a single row. And this option of arrange by column will arrange all the artboards in a single column. At last, this button will change the order of artboards from left to right to left, which is most commonly used in Middle Eastern countries. You can set the spacing between artboards by entering space value right here. Remember, this alignment is just for your viewing convenience while working on multi-artboard assignment, and there is nothing technical about it. However, we have a lot more things to learn about these options, which we'll be covering in the forthcoming lessons about the artboard. Then we have the unit. It means the unit of measurement that will go throughout your entire work on a particular document. There are 6 options to choose from. For the matter of information, 72 points, which is written as PT in Illustrator, is equal to 1 inch, which is written as IN in Illustrator. 1 inch is equal to 6 picas, which is written as P in Illustrator. The pica is a typographic unit of measure. The pica contains 12 units of measure, meaning 8 inches will be 8 multiply 6, that will be 48 picas. And 8.3 inches will be 8.3 multiply 6, that is equal to 49.8 picas. But since picas has 12 units of measure, it is written as 12 multiply 0.8, that is equal to 9.6. And that makes 49 picas and 9.6 as its fraction. A lot of maths we have discussed here, so no more maths now. So likewise, we have centimeters, we have millimeters. These are quite known options. At the end, we have pixels. A thing to notice here is Illustrator assumes 1 inch equals 72 pixels. However, an average screen nowadays comes with 100 to 120 pixels per inch. This is the minimum I'm saying, and you may have high PPI screen. In a precise work of making icons, this unit measure is adopted. For example, 16 by 16 pixels or 32 by 32 pixels. For the matter of fact, the maximum size that can be entered here is 2 to 7.54 inches. If you need to output your work at a larger scale, you will need to import it at a higher than needed resolution into your image editing software, for example Photoshop, and then change the resolution without resampling. This is a quite technical stuff if you are a beginner to Illustrator, and we are going to cover everything in future lessons. Then we have orientation. It can be portrait or the landscape. Then we have bleed value. Now this thing is exclusively related to chapter of how to print, and we'll be having a detailed discussion on it in future lessons. For now, you being newbie to Illustrator, you can leave these values to be zero. Then we have advanced options, under which the first thing is color. A CMYK means cyan, magenta, yellow and key color, that is black. This option is chosen if you are working exclusively for print purposes, because printers work with these inks. Second option is RGB, which means red, green and blue. These are the display colors of monitor, which means if your final output is to be displayed on monitor, only then you work under this setting. Second thing is raster effect. This setting is used to set the pixel density while working with effects in your document, because some effects in Illustrator are pixel based rather than vector based, for example drop shadow effect. So if the final output is gonna be a print document, then set 300 ppi, which means 300 pixels per inch, which will appear quite smooth on your paper. If it is gonna be a screen or web document, then 72 ppi is perfect setting for you. Illustrator by default makes you work in a vector based environment. In case you want to change the preview of your artwork as pixel view, you can change it right here. You may also want to see the pixel view of your artwork to see how it looks like, because your final output will be saved as a pixel based image only. Here is another option of preview, that is overprint, which I'll discuss in detail in future chapters. Then we have align new objects to pixel grid. Now this is yet another option which requires a bit detailed discussion, which I will explain you in later chapters for sure. For the matter of fact, it is good to take this option if your artwork is not too advanced. There is another option as well, which is transparency grid. This option appears when you choose video and film as profile. Actually, when you create an artwork specifically to be displayed over a movie clip, you would want a transparent background so that your artwork displays as an individual piece of art over the movie. So this option gives you choice to choose the type of grid to be used while you work in Illustrator, like light, dark, red, and many more. You may also turn off the transparency grid. Now, a detailed discussion on the use of video and film profile will be done in future chapters. So for now, you can leave it. Remember, you can always change the settings you set initially right here in the dialog box anytime while working as well. And we'll be discussing about this in the future chapters. So this is the way you start with a new document in Illustrator. In the next lesson, we'll learn about Artboard. Thanks for watching NagGraphics, and stay tuned for the forthcoming lessons.